Speak your truth. No censorship and no morality. The only place you can express yourself without limit.
Just say it.
On 99.9 FM.
You're listening to Anarchy Radio.
You can say anything. You can be anyone. Unleash the power of freedom on the Anarchy Radio Show. No censorship until I decide to push the red button. And that's when I decided y'all had bored me to death. Because I am in control, motherfuckers. And speaking of control, that is the topic for today. Are you a freedom seeker or a control freak? Call us right now because the air is yours. What do we have on the line, Speed?
Got Brenda from downtown on the line.
What's up, Brenda? What do you have to say for us?
I think we live in a society that lacks control at every level. And if there is no control, it's just chaos, you know? I mean, look at all these people. They're jumping out of their windows lately. And I think that we should install CCTV cameras in the homes of every psychologically unstable person. And also the ex-convicts. I mean, it's a shame.
Wow. Seems like Big Brother was a sister today, huh? Next!
We got Rob from New York on the line!
New York? I didn't even know we broadcasted that far. What's up, Rob? How you doing?
We are more and more to listen to you guys in the Big Apple. Anyway, I think that control, or better said, the obsession for control, is a disease of the human beings. I mean, look at all these multi-billionaire guys, the top executives, the kings and the dictators. They must be absolutely terrified of their surroundings to need that much control. They should be treated in the mental hospitals, these people. It's so sad, don't you think?
I love it. All these guys in the nut house? What a party. More. We want more of your visions and opinions about control. Call us right here on Anarchy Radio to speak your truth. The only radio you could do it before the end of the world. But before that, let's hear the crazy tune of the Nut House. Hey DJ, will you turn that up?
Andy, I gotta talk about you something important, man.
What?
You found more booze in it somewhere?
No, it's...
You're getting married? Hey, everybody! Speed's getting married! Woo!
You're a dead man now, motherfucker.
It's about the radio.
What about the goddamn radio? Later, Speed.
Bye.
Who's in control now?
Thank you.
White. Hello, my love. How's your head?
Hey, baby. I'm fine.
You had more alcohol than blood in your bloodstream yesterday. But I'm sure you haven't forgotten about your big interview today, right?
Shit. No, baby. I didn't forget. I was getting ready right now.
Great. See you then.
Bye. Oh, fuck.
Exuberant, provocative, for some, out of line.
Aggressive, even decadent. How do you explain all these titles you've been granted?
The moment you come out of your cave, people start judging and calling you names. I'd rather be called that than just some guy on the radio. I'm happy to be labeled as a troublemaker.
So how does it feel to become the talk of the day in this Renaissance, new age of radio?
I don't really care about being famous. What I do care about is freeing people's mind. I'm fed up of people telling me what to do, what to wear, how to feel, what to think. All these people, big brands, institutions, and onto us 24/7? It's unbearable. So pardon my French, but fuck them. And my only mission, so to speak, is to restore a space of freedom, especially to the kids and teenagers, because they are the main targets to the big businesses and morality mind controllers.
You're a fucking rock star, my love. I mean, after that interview, the audience is gonna explode.
Yeah? You sure about that?
Hey, who's the manager here? I know my shit. It's going to boom. I can guarantee that.
Yeah. A local confidential boom, maybe.
What? Hey, Mr. Big Head, you're not a big star yet, I get it. Things take time, okay? But if it's too slow for you, feel free to go find another dumbhead to act as your manager.
It was a joke. Come on, I'm just busting your balls. Your beautiful, hairy balls. A sexy little nut pack. Look, I'm really happy with you, all right? You're terrific.
Really?
Yeah. Your work is awesome. I couldn't dream of a better manager. You're the best, sexiest manager on the planet.
You bet. What?
Speed. I know.
This better be important, buddy. Pretty busy and I got a sexy little thing waiting at home, know what I'm saying? And what's up with all the secrecy? You can't talk on the phone or what? Being chased by the mob or something?
It's complicated.
Sounds time consuming. Do we have to do it now?
Yes, it's important.
All right, let's hear it.
It's about the radio.
We're not buying any more stuff, Speed. The sound is good enough.
Shut the fuck up, man. God. It's not about the gear. We found something.
What did you find?
I'm not crazy, okay? I think someone is using our frequency.
What?
Yeah, but it's not audible.
What do you mean, not audible?
I don't know how they do it, but somehow they're using our frequency to broadcast some sort of shadow wave. I need to do more research.
Does it affect the quality or the range of the broadcast?
No, not at all. It's transparent. You can't hear it, but I think it affects people.
Affects people? Who? How?
I don't know, like maybe the nervous system or something? It's hard to say.
Wait. Is everything okay? You're not using it again, are you?
Fuck, dude, I'm clean, man. It's been years. You don't believe me, do you?
I don't know. Sounds a bit weird, don't you think?
Okay.
Wait, Speed! What the fuck, man?
Facts, people?
This world is getting crazy. It's driving people insane. Even my best friend Speed is going crazy. The number of murders, attacks, suicides, and violent crimes are skyrocketing. This is an epidemic. Are we reaching our end of our ability to survive? What the fuck is happening to the human race? Thanks for sending us the footage, Jimmy. Y'all could go see it online now if you want, but I have to warn you, it's really disturbing. So Jimmy, you were witnessing this outside your office? Is that correct?
Yeah, I was in my office when I saw that on the security camera system. People running and this guy. I couldn't do anything but call the cops, but it went so fast. I mean, it was over before the 911 operator could even understand the situation.
That must have been very traumatic, Jimmy. So what is your opinion on this exponential rise in violence recently?
I don't know, man, but it was very disturbing. Especially after the fact when I went down to help the victims. There was blood everywhere. I couldn't help but think about if that was someone in my family. Even the cops, they said they hadn't seen many cases like that ever. Even if the authorities try to minimize the scope of these events by cooking the numbers, everybody feels there is something wrong.
Well, thank you again, Jimmy. Again, I am very sorry about what you went through, and I wish you the best, my man.
Now we have on the line is a member of the police forces, which of course is not allowed to talk about any of these issues. She was explicitly prohibited by her hierarchy to talk or mention anything about it. So, that is why we're going to scramble her voice to get around the fucking legal censorship. You're on the air, Sarah.
Thanks for allowing the people to talk freely.
That's what we do. So what is the reason you can't talk or mention any details about it?
Actually, it's very simple. The situation is exceptional and is getting out of hand. Violent crimes have more than tripled in the last few months, and so are suicides. So, in order to avoid panic or just more questioning, we are simply ignoring the public debate.
What do you mean you don't want more? You don't like it? You think I'm a lousy cook, don't you?
What? No, I don't.
What, it's not fancy enough? I'm not good enough? Are you saying I'm a bad mother?
But Mom, I didn't say anything.
Got you! You believe me, didn't you?
Yeah, you got me for sure.
Oh, it's acting. I've taken an acting class with my friends, and our coach says we should practice anywhere, anytime, in, you know, real life situations. Oh, that coach, he's something else.
Your father, he would have liked him.
What I wouldn't give for just one more hour with your father.
I know.
How are you doing since, you know?
I keep busy, you know, but I really, really wish you'd come around more often. You could come to my performance. It's in 2 months. Will you come?
Absolutely. I wouldn't miss your premiere on the big stage. That's gonna be something.
Hello? Too bad. Not me. Leave my stupid robot assistant a message.
Shit! Hey, Speed. We're on the air in 1 fucking minute. How am I supposed to do everything by myself? Move your fucking ass, man. Now! Unfucking believable.
Total freedom. Speak your truth. No censorship and no morality. The only place you can express yourself without limit.
Just say it.
On 99.9 FM.
You're listening to Anarchy Radio.
You can say anything. You can be anybody. Unleash the power of freedom on the Anarchy Radio Show.
Too bad. Not me. Leave my stupid robot assistant a message, motherfucker.
Answer the fucking phone, Speed. What the hell's the matter with you? Fuck.
Not me. Leave my stupid robot assistant a message, motherfucker.
Pick up. Hey, Speed, open up, man. Speed, we gotta work. Speed. Speed.
Andy, I hope you find this letter before them, brother. Can't tell you much about them other than that they're evil. Pure fucking evil. Everything I know about them is in a little box. Every time I try to tell you about it, I couldn't figure out how to put it without sounding completely mental. You know how high I have you in my esteem. You know I'm kind of crazy. No one knows me better than you. Not even my own mom. But I'm not that crazy. I feel the pressure going up. I'm losing control. I can feel it. Really sorry to leave you alone, but it's beyond me now. Maybe we'll meet again in Valhalla. Some dirty, greasy joint in another life. I would love that. Take care, brother. I'm so sorry.
Glory to His Majesty, Great Pharaoh, Sun God, Light of the World. Hail to his glory in the kingdom to come. He will reign amongst humans. I am your slave. Please come down now. Yours is my command. Your wish 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 is my command.
How's the project going?
Everything is going according to plan, sir.
Good. Is the technology giving the expected result?
I'm no expert, sir. Pardon my ignorance, but I don't know exactly what is expected. However, according to our technicians, it seems to be working pretty well.
You don't know?
I wasn't entirely briefed about the experiment, sir.
Good. You can go now.
Thank you, sir.
Greasy joy in another life.
I don't have much time left. I know they are after me, and I doubt it will take very long for them to catch up. Or worse. What I'm about to say will probably sound like I'm completely mad to most of you, but I assure you, I'm in full possession of my faculties. I am not under the influence of any substance. My name is Alfred Bauer. I am a British citizen, although my father was German. Before the war, I was working as a scientist in a worldwide collaboration, studying the effects of electronics on the human brain. It was an international secret scientific community with American, English, and German scientists funded by private investors. I was recruited by the British Army to monitor my group, the German group, and transmit back our discoveries. We were working on the idea of influencing human thought with special electronic devices called entropic sound wave generators, some sort of sound frequency machines. The goal, officially, was to end all human conflict and bring peace on Earth. And we found out there was a way to do it. Influence thought at a distance. But it was just a theory at the time. After the war was declared, I had to make a choice. And I decided to stay in Germany under my German identity and keep on surveying these activities for the British Crown. Even though the war was declared, some American and English scientists kept on communicating with the German group. I was reporting the best I could under the circumstances, as the Gestapo was on edge. In a very short period of time, we made tremendous progress, as we had unlimited human subjects to experiment on. What I saw there, I'd rather forget it if I could. We could influence the willpower of a person at a short distance and in accordance to his moral values at first. But then, we succeeded in having someone cutting his own throat with a razor blade and a smile. Was terrifying. The electrical power needed was enormous, and the device filled up a whole building. Even with this breakthrough, we were still years away from making it useful at a practical level. But then, I saw with my own eyes someone taking complete control of a prisoner. So easily, I couldn't believe it. I looked to see if it was a trick, but there was not one. This man, a foreigner, French, I believe, he was just showing us the results he was expecting from our research. But he was not using any device, no electronics, only mind power. He was playing with the prisoner like a puppet. And then he made the prisoner throw himself up against a wall. Again and again, many times, until he died. I was horrified. We all were. The cruelty of this person was just... I later understood that this man was who we were working for.
You're okay.
Do you think it's possible other intelligent entities could live on the same planet as us?
Yeah, dolphins?
Nah, something undetected, advanced, extremely advanced.
Aliens?
Yeah, sort of.
Do you really want to go there? Promise me you won't tell anybody.
Of course.
I wasn't born in Kentucky like I told you. And my name is not Ella.
What?
My name is Frankenfrasnutz Briggs. And if you tell anybody, I will vaporize you.
on, baby. I'm just trying to cheer you up.
Very funny. Do you think he was crazy?
Speed? Fine, crazy. We're all crazy. I mean,
he was a great friend and a very, very decent person. But you never know what's going on inside someone's head.
I should have been there for him. I should have listened.
Baby.
What kind of friend was I?
Hey, it is not your fault. He was probably depressed for a long time, hiding it behind his goofy attitude. Sometimes the funniest people on earth are...
What if he didn't kill himself?
He did. You know that. You found him.
What if someone helped him to do so?
Stop torturing yourself, Andy. People are committing suicide every day for their own personal reasons that you're not part of. You are not responsible.
Yeah, maybe. I know it looks totally crazy. I don't even know if I believe it for myself. But something tells me that I don't go shake that tree.
I'll never understand what happens to my best friend, Speed. And I'll never forgive myself for that. Worst case scenario, I make a total fool out of myself. Who gives a fuck?
We are under attack, and this is not a figure of speech. It's 12:45, I'm in my studio, and it feels like I'm talking from an underground bunker. Some of you are gonna think I've completely lost my mind, but I'm not talking to you. I'm calling upon the others, the freedom seekers, the resistance, the free spirits. My friends, we are under attack. I've come to the conclusion that some dark, sinister organization is using this very frequency to broadcast in a way that is technically impossible for me to describe. An inaudible, undetectable signal that is affecting us in many ways. It's affecting our minds and our mental health. They are willing to take control over our minds. My friends, we are under attack. I had no other option, so I'm calling upon you. If anybody has any information how to detect, isolate, or stop, please step forward. We are at war. You're on the air.
Absolutely amazing. I could not stop listening. It was so realistic. It reminded me of that production in the 30s, The War of the Worlds. That's it. Andy, I loved it. I am totally...
Holy shit! Is that the new angle you're cooking all this time? Fictionist drama, real lifestyle radio? You may have something here, my love. Oh wait, it's modern and vintage. At the same time, I'd love the idea. Too bad I wasn't there to witness your face when you were on the air. It must have been epic. You should have told me. Andy? Hello? He hung up on me?
I hope we're not interrupting anything.
Who the fuck are you? How did you get in? It's not open to the public.
I'm so sorry, I didn't know that. The door was open.
No, it wasn't.
Are you sure? Maybe my friend over here pushed a little too hard. I'm sorry. He can't control his strength sometimes.
Like I said, it's not open to the public, so...
Relax, Andrew. We'll just be a minute.
Who are you?
We are the future. I am a huge fan of yours. I think you have tremendous talent. Tremendous, really. But you are wasting it by not getting the audience you deserve. And we can change that. We can help you get to the next level.
We? Who is we?
We think that you're the perfect fit for the big game.
What game?
National audience. Maybe even TV, who knows? When I see talent, I know it. And you, Indy, you've got it. You've made your point. You've attracted our attention.
Thank you. I'm flattered, really. But you didn't answer my question. Who is we?
I represent a group of people that are, let's say, success makers. See, what you lack, we have. The network, the finance, the leverage, the power to push people to the stars. And we have big plans for you, Andy.
Big plans? At 4 a.m.?
The early bird gets the worm. I'm sure you're going to be interested in what we have to offer.
I'm all ears. So who do I have to kill?
Andy, this is exactly what we love about you. Your sense of humor, the provocation, the irreverence. You won't have to kill anyone, of course. But just maybe letting die these stupid little stories about conspiracy and control and power that, frankly, between you and me, no one gives a damn about.
No. But you do. Give a damn about it.
Not at all. We think about what's best for you. We think mainstream. And you could be our next bet.
Sure. Why not? It's time for me to move up. I'll think about it.
Wonderful. Here's my card.
Don't take too long, though. This is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity.
Who are these people? What the fuck just happened? You struck a nerve here, buddy.
So? Hold your horses, son. You alone?
Yeah, why?
The best I can tell you is you don't want to know.
The fuck is that? You said.
All right. You do want to know, fine.
What?
The money, son. Look, I get it. You're a fucking cowboy. You want to go digging into that shit. Be my guest. But don't complain when you end up covered in shit, all right? These people, I don't know that much about them. They're no fucking joke. They don't like little dogs like you sniffing up their asses.
What does that mean?
It means they're very powerful and extremely dangerous.
How dangerous?
Like the type you can end up in a hole in the desert dangerous. You get me? Now you've had your warning. Do what you want, but you leave me out of it. Do you understand? I need you to say it and mean it.
I understand.
I don't know you. You don't know me. We've never met.
Hi, Andy. I hope you're well. I was just calling to check if you've given some thought to our previous conversation. I haven't heard from you, so I thought I'd give you a call. Our offer still stands. Okay, call me back, please. Have a great day.
Hello, you have requested the report 8767B for security reason. We recommend to isolate yourself or to listen to the report with earphones. Press play to start. KMX Media is a global media company active in Europe, America, North and South, and Asia. KMX is owned and controlled through different other companies by Day Corporation.
Day Corporation?
Press more to go on. Day Corporation is a multinational investment company based in Luxembourg, Europe. Founded in 1933, initially as a risk management and fixed income institutional asset manager, DAIG is one of the world's largest asset manager. Press more to go on to the analysis. Day Corporation has a unique structure that makes its ownership very difficult to discern. It is in some way owned by the companies it is owning. DAIG is present in many sectors such as media, banking, military equipments, private security, private military, energy, pharmaceutical, food and transports. It has been accused of largely influencing institutions and governments, particularly in West Africa. It was suspected of having ties with Nazi Germany, but all investigations were inconclusive or aborted. End of report.
Ties with the Nazis? Holy shit.
What the fuck, Andy? I work my ass off to bring us to the next level, and when the opportunity knocks at the door, you want to turn it off? Without even mentioning it to me? So if I hadn't received this contract, I probably would have never heard about it. Is that how you trust me? Is that your definition of partnership? Hey, I'm here. Are you gonna say something?
It didn't seem right to me.
It didn't. Oh, really? I'm sorry. I don't wanna hurt your feelings here or your sixth sense. But can you fucking explain?
I don't know. It was too good to be true. These guys? It didn't seem right to me.
Not straight enough, hon? Welcome to the show business, my little chicken.
They broke in!
Yeah, you probably left the door open.
No, I didn't. I was sure about that.
Can the whiskey bottle testify for you?
I only had a couple, who cares? But why break in at 4 a.m.?
That's how bad they want you.
Yeah, right. Why'd they need a big-ass dude to make a proposal other than just to threaten me?
Why would they threaten you? Why would a multinational media corporation be afraid of you, darling?
Something about the frequency narrative they didn't like.
Come on! They don't give a shit about that! The guy was huge, so what? Do you know what they do when they want to impress people? They don't send muscle, that's the mob. They send an out-of-this-world expensive lawyer team.
They didn't seem right to me. That guy was really creepy. Something evil.
My poor darling, you are getting totally paranoid.
Oh,
This is Paranoia Monday on Anarchy Radio. And if you don't like it, well, fuck off. And turn to some old lady radio station where everything's all sweet, purple, and dandy. And I'm so not sorry to bother you guys about my moods and feelings, because what is a human being without any moods and feelings but a vulgar piece of meat? This is Paranoia Monday.
Because our dear friend Speed, beloved radio tech, brother in arms, just ended his life in a very tragic way.
And I feel like someone helped him to do so.
This is Paranoia Monday because just right after that, just asking you people for help about a secret manipulation of this radio waves, I received a visit from the nicest businesswoman in the world with the best proposal for my career. How great, right?
And such a fucking coincidence.
And last but not least,
this is Paranoia Monday because I'm going to disclose to you the name of this giant corporation and see if you guys could find out all the information you can about these guys and see if I survive. Come on, my friends.
The line is open. Bring it on!
They talk about you. Look.
I can assure you, I have
no personal ties whatsoever to that corporation, so my opinion here is just a humble professional opinion.
So what is your take on this frontal attack from our beloved Andy Winter? Is it a publicity move of some sort to attract more audience, or more personal vendetta?
I'm a fan of Anarchy Radio. And freedom of speech in general. But as we know, with freedom also comes responsibilities. So sending a declaration of war without any proof to a respectable corporation like that is a little bit dangerous.
Especially when you do have some influence.
You need to be careful because some people may act upon whatever you tell them.
So what is it all about?
It's hard to say, but I think they're drifting into a real paranoia here. And I don't mean to be disrespectful, but we should face it. The whole thing
comes from allegations of an ex-drug addict with a strong psychiatric background.
You're referring to Speed, the radio technician who hanged himself.
Yes, and it was a tragic event, not only for his friends,
his family, but the entire radio world in general.
And with these extremely dramatic events, to an already fragile mind,
it can cause a lot of disturbance.
You're saying that Andy Winter switched?
After his best friend's death?
I wouldn't say it in those terms, but that is a possibility. I mean, when you
really look at it, the whole thing is a total delirium. It's a blatant case of conspiracy theory. I mean, why a huge multinational corporation would choose a quite insignificant underground radio station to conduct a, quote, mass mind control experiment. That's pure science fiction, and that person should write science fiction novels. But unfortunately, the case is more serious. It's characteristic of what we call persecution syndrome. It's a disease, commonly known as paranoia. And if not taken care of, it can lead to some very dangerous and harmful situations.
They've unleashed the dogs.
Yes, sir. We've already taken the appropriate measures. He won't be a problem. I'll take care of it personally. Thank you for your call, sir.
Be okay.
Yes, it is. It's beautiful. Thank you.
There is a legend of two brothers, two creatures coming from another world. And they have the power to control the human mind. But they have a profound disagreement. One just wants to live peacefully on Earth and enjoy his talent with a very light touch, respecting nature and the humans, when the other one, he craves for power, control. He wants to be venerated like a god, to become a pharaoh, the emperor of the human race. But of course, it's just an old legend.
Where can I meet you?
I know exactly how these people operate. If you are a little bit itchy, they'll try to bribe you. They did. Then they'll try to discredit you. That's where we are. And if that's not enough, they'll try to erase you. And I need to be ready for that because I know. What the fuck? Holy shit, I'm going crazy!
Drive.
Speed?
It's not safe here, drive.
What?
Fucking drive!
Up here, turn here. Speed. Stop here. It's safe.
How is this possible?
I'm dead, man. You killed me.
No. No, I didn't.
You let me down.
I'm sorry.
Why didn't you listen to me?
I don't know.
You won't survive this. You're too strong. And they don't even exist.
What does that mean?
You won't prove anything. I know that now. Would you come join me, brother? I'm peaceful now. No troubles.
You're not Speed. You're not my friend. You're not him. You're not him! Get out! Get out!
You're not crazy, Andrew. Relax. Hallucinations can be brought on by a litany of things. Burnout, lack of sleep, food poisoning, viruses, psychotropic substances.
I don't take any of that stuff, Doc.
Good. Good. Well, we'll run some blood tests, get a better idea. In the meantime, relax, and I'll write you some scripts to help you get back to good old reality. Sound like a plan?
Yeah. Sounds great.
Good. Any dental work recently?
Dental work?
Did you know that during World War II, a California woman claimed she was picking up radio broadcasts in her dental fillings?
Radio?
Radio waves. Well, when it happened again a week later, she told the police because the signal sounded like Morse code. Later, she stated that the FBI located the source of the signal. Turns out, it was an underground Japanese radio station. Can you believe it? I love stories like that. Anyway, take your meds, avoid mixing with alcohol. You'll be fine.
So what did he say?
I'm not crazy. Sorry.
Of course. Stupid. What else?
Food poisoning, stress, whatever.
What did you expect? That's the only thing these people know. Giving people fucking pills.
See, that's why I wanted to come with you. You don't say anything. You keep it all to yourself.
I'm not crazy!
Nothing's ever good enough for you, is it?
Hello, Andrew. Please, take a seat. I'm sorry about all this. I'm not comfortable meeting people physically, so I use that trick.
Okay. Fine by me.
What can I do for you?
The legend you're talking about.
What about it?
I want to know more.
You sure about that?
Look, I'm sick and tired of people telling me what I want or don't want, okay? What you were talking about? I don't think it's just a legend. I think you called the radio station because you know what's really going on. And I feel like you want to do something about it.
Why do you think that?
Can we cut the bullshit? I just been through a fucked up experience and I have a feeling it has nothing to do with bad luck or food poisoning. So tell me, what the fuck do you know about these two twin brothers?
You know, Andy, knowledge is a double-edged dagger.
A dagger, huh? Here we go. Go on.
Nobody knows where they came from. Nobody really knows why and when they came. The only thing we know for sure is that they have this tremendous power of controlling people's minds. Like puppeteers, if you like. And fortunately for us, they are in conflict, one against the other. We call them controllers. The corporation is just a tool to be able to maneuver more widely in this world. And we believe they are experimenting a way to control more people at once using radio waves.
Why do they want to control people?
Why do cats hunt mice? It's the nature.
But why me? Why my radio station? It doesn't make any sense.
It makes perfect sense. They may be just starting up, and they want to stay hidden. You're probably not the only radio they're using. You just stumble on it. Well, your technician did. You didn't keep your mouth shut. But I could have you. They flagged you. Now, you're in big trouble.
So what can I do?
Accept their offer. Swallow the whole thing. Pray they won't succeed. Forget about it and live your own life.
Are you serious?
Oh, yes. That's my best advice. The alternative would be Andy against Goliath.
Talk to me, Andy.
What?
Something isn't right. What is it? Why won't you talk to me?
I don't know. What do you mean, what?
I'm not stupid, Andy. You stare at the ceiling for hours. You haven't touched me for days. You haven't said a word.
Calm down.
I am calm. I'm super calm. But I can't stand it! Something is wrong with you and you're just shutting me out.
I'm here.
I know. I'm sorry. I'm just... maybe I'm just a little bit tired. That's it, all right? I just need some time off.
For me?
No, no. That's not what I meant. I've just been washed up the last couple days and it's nothing.
If you don't talk to me, I start to feel excluded from your life and I feel like you don't want me anymore.
Absolutely not. I need you in my life. I love you.
So what's happening then?
Nothing.
Marty, you have a gun.
What?
See? I ask a simple question and you act as if you don't even know what I'm talking about. Why do you have a gun, Andy?
I don't know.
You know I hate these things.
I don't know.
You don't know? You don't know why you have a loaded gun in the apartment? It just landed here?
No, of course not.
So why?
For protection.
Protection from who?
In general. It's getting dangerous out there, all right? Don't you see? The shootings, the attacks, the suicides. Do you really think that's normal? People are losing their fucking minds and I felt like I needed protection. For me, for you, and just in case. Just in case.
I don't know what's going on with you, Andy. But it feels like you're just slipping through my fingers like sand. And it feels like I'm losing you.
Where are you going?
Somewhere. Good evening, my love. How are you today? How about a nice romantic dinner? I bought a delicious red wine.
We need to talk.
No.
I've thought this through. I think it's best if I'm alone for a little while.
Are you breaking up with me?
No, no. It's just, I don't know. I got some things I gotta take care of, and I don't wanna get you any trouble, all right?
I wanna help you, Andy.
I know, babe. But I don't think you can.
Because you closed the door. Why don't you talk to me?
I just wanna protect you.
I don't need to be protected. I'm not made of glass.
I know, but...
But what? If you cut me off, I can't help you. I already told you that. And if you reject me, I won't stand it. I'm not expendable. You don't put me in a closet. I'm not a doll. And I'm not gonna sit here on the side and wait for you to kill yourself.
I'm not gonna kill myself.
I'm warning you, Andy. If I walk through this door, I'm not coming back. Is this really what you want? Answer me!
Ooh, you should have listened.
What? Who the fuck are you?
I don't know. I don't care. I'm his hand and his will. Can you spare a dollar or two, my friend? Just die, miserable creature.
Fucking crazy, man?
Nothing personal. You gotta go, that's all. I don't wanna do it, but who am I to decide?
You can decide if you wanna keep your disgusting, atrophied brain in one piece or not. Drop the gun. Now go smoke your brain liquefying shit somewhere else. You're welcome.
No. Sorry. Thank you.
The fuck are you doing here at this hour? Are you suicidal?
Not sure.
Think you had enough.
Fuck, man.
You don't look like you live in the streets. What's your story?
I wouldn't know where to start, sir.
You can call me General.
Wow. A real general, then. I guess you were the cavalry coming in, huh?
Yes, mister. Somebody needs to do something about what is happening in our streets, right? Well, that's what I do. What about you?
I'm just a radio guy. And I stepped in some really big trouble.
What kind of trouble?
Like, kind of think I'm totally crazy?
Try me. So it has started.
What has started?
The invasion.
Invasion?
Who do you think has the resources to set up such an operation? I only see two, the Russian or the Chinese. I knew it. I was waiting for it. I told them, but they wouldn't listen.
Who?
The government. They probably already have infiltrated the highest strata. We're exactly in phase one of an invasion. They're creating the conditions to favor an attack. You know, I live in the streets by choice. I'm here to observe and analyze. And what you're telling me is the very confirmation of what I'm witnessing every day.
What's that exactly?
Massive increase of violence, attacks, suicide. People have no will anymore. They are more and more depressed and zombified. And you, my friend, have discovered the source. When a large enough number of the population will be affected, our defenses will be weak. And that's when they will launch the operation. First sending special forces to sabotage the infrastructures, then massive bombing, and finally, the troops. And if we don't do anything, we'll be speaking Chinese in no time, or Russian.
So what about the Nazis? Are they part of this or what?
I don't buy the Nazi thing and the non-human bullshit story. It's just a smokescreen to hide the real threat.
So what can we do?
Preventive strike. Bomb them before they bomb us.
Bomb?
I can abandon my cover now. I'm not needed in the streets anymore. I will go talk to my contact at the CIA first thing in the morning. Stay put. We'll contact you. Watch the news. Maybe in 12 hours, Beijing will be reduced in ashes, or Moscow.
Another fucking lunatic. Shit.
To make an effective, powerful bomb, it's not as complicated as people think. You could easily find everything in the form of a legal house product you could purchase in a supermarket or a general store. I'm going to teach you exactly how to do that step by step. But first, subscribe to my channel.
Strike first.
Found you, little rat.
My son.
Aww.
Oh, it's so good to hear your voice. How's everything?
Is everything okay? You sound tired.
No, I'm good. I just wanted to call and check up on you. Not a particular reason.
Well, I'm just here with my friends and we're playing cards and guess who's here? Your Aunt Martha. You want to talk to her?
No, not right now. I don't have much time.
Well then, how is that lovely Ella? How's she doing? Is she around?
She's good. She says hi. Listen, I have to go now, Mom.
Okay then, okie dokie. I'll see you soon, okay? Love you, son.
Okay, Mom.
Bye.
Bye.
That was my son.
Tonight is a dark night. The darkest night I've ever lived. It's darker than the cold emptiness of space where blind, hideous creatures are conspiring in whispers. Sun Tzu wrote, "The secret lies in confusing the enemy so that he cannot fathom our true intent." And confused we are. A crazy wise man once told me to always strike first. I'm no warmonger, but sometimes one has to defend himself and his people against pure evil. And the only thing no enemy can ever anticipate is the unpredictability of pure chaos. The very essence of freedom. Maybe the sun will rise. Or maybe not. So long, my friends.
You've reached the end of the line.
What else can you do?
Take it. Take it. Isn't that beautiful? Look at all the perfection in the fine details. Can you imagine the power held in this little piece of metal? Now cock the gun. Press it to your temple. You're almost there. Your suffering's almost over. You will be free. Totally free. Forever. Now pull the trigger. Come on. Do it. Do it, Andy. Do it. Please. Do it. Do it.
I won't let you! I get you.
Please don't hurt me.
You're a fucking monster. You're not human. You don't deserve to live.
Wait. Don't do that.
Why not?
I'm not responsible for your problems, and I was just following orders. I'm nobody.
So nobody will miss you.
I can help you! Killing me won't get you anywhere. Trust me, they'll just replace me. Andy, they'll just replace me. Trust me. Look, I'm sorry. I really am. I didn't know what I was doing. They kept me in the dark the whole time. I'm just a cog in the machine. I was just supposed to overview a tiny, tiny part of the operation.
What operation?
I don't know the whole picture. I know they were experimenting with radio waves on a national scale, like a medical experiment. Oh, so I was told. But you started to become a problem, so my job was just to recruit you and to divert the public's attention from the operation. That's it. But I failed. I got in trouble like you, Andy.
Great fucking story.
No! Please, no, Andy! Why do you think I'm here? Why? Huh? With this guy? He's watching me, Andy! They took my freedom away from me.
Shut the fuck up!
Radio anchor and notorious conspiracy theorist has gone into a spiral of madness. What do you think, Professor?
It's really sad, I must say. This talented young man just snapped. We were warned by some signs of paranoid drift lately, and one can always expect a deterioration when not properly attended. Unfortunately, we were right, and what should inevitably happen, happened. My only hope is that he can be captured without harming any more people and can be treated by professionals as everyone has the right to be.
My name, Andrew Winterfield, Andy Winter for my fans. I was the host of the infamous Anarchy radio show. And whatever you're going to hear about me has probably been written by somebody that works for them. And I'm not sure what's going to happen, but I need to record my testimony about what's happening in the world right now. Much time. They're here. They exist. And they're willing to take control over our world by submitting us. Submitting our minds. and I don't know how they do it. And unfortunately, I don't know how to stop them. They have the ability to get inside our heads, play with our thoughts, and make us do things that we don't want to do. They are trying, using a new technology to upscale their operation and take control over our world. And my only hope is somebody gets this message and finds a way to expose them or fight back. They're here. I can feel it. They want to get rid of me. I know too much.
I would never let them get control. Never!